remember what they're called though. I know they're hand gesture reactions.
A bob,
You
leg.
gotta have, oh, you gotta have at least an M1 Mac for it to work. So I don't know if that, and you, I think you've got to have Sonoma.
I've got Sonoma. I've got a new Mac Mini with an M1 chip. It should work.
I've got a Mac too.
I still want to know why I can't get the. I know I can get this, but I thought if I did two, you get like a rainstorm. It doesn't want
I'm sure these guys coming in are just wondering what the you're doing. Show them the
I
fireworks
like it,
again.
Steve.
Hey, Alan, they just think a bunch of weirdos.
Yeah.
Well, we wear that, you know, with a badge of honor. I mean, look at Steve after all.
Whoa.
I think you should leave a
David.
pirate.
That's better. So what'd you call
Do
that?
anything. I didn't do anything, just doing it. Yeah. Well, that's
You
cute.
gotta go. You gotta have
What's that?
Google Meet, Microsoft Teams, Zoom will do the trick. You gotta have that open, and then you'll go to the video menu button and make sure reactions is selected.
Okay, it could be that you don't have a reaction selected. I forgot about that. So go up to, you should see like a little green camera button in your toolbar. If you look up top above, like at the very top, if you click on that, you'll get a menu comes down. You should have reactions. If it's not highlighted, click on that.
I don't have that choice.
There's the balloons.
Yeah, but I did it by clicking on
Okay.
it. There's hand gestures
Well,
to get all of these. I don't know. Maybe it's something like this. I don't know. I don't remember them now. I know the few that I use, and I can't remember the other ones. But for every one of these that I press on, there is a hand gesture to get them to do it. Now I don't remember how.
your dad got it.
he got rockets.
They're in React.
Yeah, like I said, if you click on the camera thing that shows that your webcam is on, up top there's a menu, and you got to click on the reactions thing.
Yeah, that's.
Oh, there it is.
I could just simply click one of these little icons, and what will they do?
Click one, see what it does, Robert.
Okay.
Live dangerously.
Now let's
There you go.
try another one here.
Well, we're having fun tonight, guys.
Oh, we are.
Oh, Robert, psychedelic.
Yeah.
But I got to figure out the
I
hand gestures because there's a hand gesture that goes for all these. Maybe I gotta, you know, pat,
Balloons.
you know, do that or something. I don't know. Clench a fist. I don't know. I need to look up somewhere. I know there's a menu or it tells what all these are, but I don't remember them.
How many times do you have a meeting where every single person learns something?
Well, if you're all paying attention to me, I would like to think it's every time, but you know.
Well, we learn what we don't know, but not don't always remember it.
And sometimes what we learn turns out to be useless.
True.
I like the fireworks, but I can't get that one, Alan.
Well, it's on my reactions menu, but I don't see
By the
anything
way,
you
two
do to
thumbs
create it.
down is the rain.
Oops.
Two thumbs down is the rain?
Yes, but it didn't work when I do it.
Oh, come on now. I gotta
How do you
try
turn
this out.
the heat on? It just
There we
shows.
go. Wait, come on.
I saw one.
There we go. By the way, if you do this,
That's the balloons. You gonna
Yeah.
be in something?
Let's see here. Hold on, I had the other ones here. Hold on. Oh, do if you do two,
Your rain came down, so what can I say?
if you do this, that'll be the confetti. Just one is a balloon, two of these is a confetti.
Okay.
Nobody got it but
Well,
you.
I guess
Oh,
my
yeah.
system's too old. I'm running on Mojave.
To get the lasers, it's this. Like you're at a rock concert or something, you know?
Yeah.
It's got to be in front of your body, hold them still so it can see it.
Yeah, but mine don't do any of those. They just do it when I
Well,
push the buttons.
Alan, because I think you've got it right up on the edge here like that when you do it, like you can see it's got to be with your body frame behind it. So like change your camera angle.
That's hilarious.
Got a
That's really
bad.
hilarious.
And Dave, I think it's got to be in front of your body. I think if you go out here,
Yeah.
well, mine's still
No, I'm
working,
in the
but
front. Yeah. You have to do
and let's see if there's any I missed here. No, I think that's it. I think those are all of them.
like it. These are all
That's funny as hell.
And
you know,
Bluetooth, huh?
because you all listen to me, this is for you.
Oh.
All right, well, we can all go now.
I'll learn something.
That's our meeting for this evening. We'll be fine to
Well,
get done.
hey, it was an impromptu thing, but we all, you know, if we didn't know it, we learned it or we remembered it. I know, though, there are people I've heard talk about, like where they're in work meetings and they'll accidentally do something with their hands, like, oh, that's cool, you know, and they're not meeting because it's like a serious, you know, meeting. They're not meaning to do stuff.
Two thumbs up.
Personally, since I feel like most meetings in the world are irrelevant anyway, they could probably use this.
Yeah.
Don, why is there a football flying over your
I don't
box?
know.
And by the way, I presume that you all know that, like if you have a question, you can raise a hand to put it up in the corner. They also have, if you look down on your Zoom menu bar at the bottom, there's a thing called React, and that's where you're getting other reactions. So if you
Oh,
have the
now
raised
just a
hand,
minute
then that'll put your hand up
here.
in the corner. I actually love that little hand gesture because it's nice when you're presenting. If you're looking, you know, if you, I mean, if you have 50 people, it's hard to see, but with a smaller group like this, I like the raised hand because rather than somebody interrupting, you can see the, you know, somebody has a question.
Hilarious. That's hilarious. I got to tell you that I got to do that sometime with my counselor.
Well, there's a button down there
You
that
get a
says
good laugh
recognize.
out of it, I think.
Under the React menu in the bottom, there's a button that says it react recognize hand gestures, and it's already checked, but it didn't recognize any of mine.
Alan, I just think it doesn't like you.
I guess
It
I
I'll
made
have
it
to
react
trade
a zero.
for a new iPhone, right?
Yeah, there it
Well, Steve's got something. What was that supposed to be? The candy floating away from you?
Rocket ships.
Oh, let's take a look here at some of the. Oh, wait a second. Here's a rocket.
Alien invasion.
Looks.
Whoever thinks meetings aren't fun,
Where'd
they're
you get the
missing.
glasses, Dave?
Oh, this in the video filters.
Yeah.
I'm going manually, you know.
Oh.
I think we played with those at an officers' meeting one time last year. I don't know if you guys remember that.
Yeah.
I think I'm Shrek now.
You remember the attorney that got stuck with a kitty cat?
Yeah, I couldn't figure out what to
Yeah,
do.
he couldn't get the filter off. And
Yeah.
the
Learn
judge
how to
asked
conduct
him,
a meeting that way.
are you there? Yes, I am. I am not a kitty
Mine
cat. I
was
am an attorney.
stopped at
Yeah,
the
because
man
it was
doing
his
so much
face.
work. I came in the middle of it. Yeah, his granddaughter changed that on him.
And they were recording it, yes.
I hope he won the case.
Got it.
Dave, well, it would be hard for the jury to get mad.
Like that. Party time.
Unless right. They don't like cats.
Now that we've accomplished this, Ron, should we start with our actual program?
Everybody watching.
Enough levity. Okay. John's here. He's our president. Steve's here. He's our first vice president. Glenn's our second VP. Alan's our treasurer, and I'm the secretary. This month, of course, Glenn will visit AI from last month and ICE, iPhone 16. In October, a review of iOS features, iOS 18 features, and November, Mac OS Sequoia. Is there anybody that has a question for the group?
There is a little problem that I've had when I've used mail, and that basically I get the spinning beach ball.
What are you doing when you get the beach ball?
Basically, of all things, I'm just simply trying to download messages.
It could be that it's just not
good connection.
Yeah, good connection or not enough bandwidth or something. I don't know.
Okay. I'm just wondering if there's a, I don't know if it would do when you're downloading, but I'm wondering if it's, is it just sit and does it and then you have to quit the program?
That's pretty much what I have to do. Yes.
I wonder, and I don't remember it. I know you used to be able to do this and I haven't, I probably as a way to do it. I don't know off the top of my head. I'm wondering if it's something like with your mail database getting corrupted and it's causing that kind of problem.
Well, hell's bells.
I'm wondering if there's a way to like rebuild the mail database. And I don't know how. I know that's something you could do in the past. I haven't.
No, I know. Yeah.
Something is causing it to like get confused and not be sure what to do.
Well, I've got years worth of messages here. Just a second, see if I could bring it up.
When's the last time you shut down your computer and restarted?
Generally, I shut it down in the evenings.
Completely shut down?
Completely shut down.
And that's not the problem.
Yeah, right.
That's usually the first thing that the techies will tell you to do is restart.
Basically, I could just simply go ahead and say force quit.
Have you checked memory resources?
Just simply says not responding right now.
Have you got all your updates down?
What?
Have you got all your updates installed?
As far as I know.
Okay.
Force it to quit. Okay, it's out.
Well, we have no solution to that. So anything else, a question there?
I mean, basically, I've gone over to the Apple store a couple of times to try to get the problem resolved.
And they haven't been able to figure it out?
They haven't figured it out for the life of them. I'm sorry. Now, I have thought of all things about putting in another mail program and basically just simply let Apple Mail sit for a while, basically because of all things I've got this kind of problem.
Does it do that all the time, Robert?
It's been doing it over, for some time over the past, I'd say roughly about maybe the past few weeks.
If you load your iCloud.
I'm sorry?
There's too many people talking. Have you loaded your iCloud account on Safari and looked at your mail? Because you can actually look at the programs there. And if it doesn't happen there, it could be your mail program in your computer.
Well, if it's corrupted, I'm going to have to probably just simply take off the stuff that basically I no longer need and just simply start using only in the current year, just simply store mail. Then after that, just simply back it up to a DVD and basically let it go at that.
Well, the only way you can reinstall mail is by, you have to do it through the system.
I know.
Yeah. But that's what you may have to do because there may be something corrupt in there that's causing that.
Right.
Hey, Ron, I had another problem. Our website has directions going to your YouTube list of programs of the last previous meetings, and it wouldn't let me get on that way. If I searched on YouTube, I found us, but I was trying to look at the last meeting again. So when I went to that the meetings page, you had a link to our list of meetings, and it failed. So check on that, will you?
Okay, I'll do that. I never go to that thing itself, but I know it works sometimes, but maybe something's corrupt on it. Who knows?
Didn't I work will check. Here today.
Vaughn, is it a time to ask a question for me?
Yeah, what you have.
Aussies.
I'm sorry?
Aussies can talk.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, good evening all. A sort of newcomer to this Zoom session here. John, Alan, Ron, I know, maybe Terry and Tammy, if they're still there, from many years ago. I've only recently returned to St. Louis, and I was a member of GAMUG for quite a few years, and I called, sent an email to John and later to Ron, asking for assistance with a problem I've got. As you can tell, I'm a bit misshapen. Both my wife and I came down with cancer last year. Sadly, I was the only one to survive, and I had a huge tumor taken out of the side of my head here. I've got a graft there. And anyway, I just saw the surgical oncologist on Friday, and he's given me a couple more years to live. And in that time, I'd like to try and put together an online memorial to my wife, Noelle, who was the activities coordinator for GAMUG for about 5 or 6 years. And I'm looking for pictures that might come from GAMUG meetings of her addressing meetings and so on. I found one or two, but they're not the best ones. I've also got quite a few hard drives that I took out of old Mac computers, an old iMac from 1998, the original Bondi Blue, possibly some SCSI drives from power computing machines from mid-1990s. And these have images on them. And even though I've tried connecting up to drives and mounting them on various devices, having a lot of trouble reading them because they're probably in different formats with different document apps and everything else on them. And I'm looking for someone who might have archived computers that I might be able to connect up to and download what I'm looking for. So I thought I'd just come along to a meeting and see what advice you may have about what could be done. I've been to Mac HQ. They suggested there was nothing in St. Louis, at least in there, as far as they knew, that could be done. Computer Solutions on Watson Road in Crestwood or Sunset Hills, that area, want at least $55 just to tell me whether they can read a hard drive, and then $150 an hour for how long it takes to download from a drive into something I can use. I was hoping that there'd be a couple of fellows still around who have an idea of maybe somewhere they've got an old computer and I can be able to connect up to it and see if I can if it'll accept the format and the apps and everything else that's on it to be able to work, because some of the stuff is in OS 6.8.1 or so. You can see how I'm looking. It's more of a an archaeological dig than a normal computer question. But if anyone's got any suggestions, one fellow I thought of was Bob McGee. Is he still around and still working?
Well,
Carl, you have an answer or a question.
Carl, you're muted.
Carl, you're muted.
Thank you. I've got a Mac 9600 that's running OS 8.1. And it's working in good condition.
Well, that's promising. Because I did have a 9500, a 9600, something like that. And these drives, when I got rid of a lot of computers, as I had to do, I at least dismantled them, and because they were often, very old, I took out the drives. And some of these drives, I don't even know where they came from, because I didn't identify each one and say this came from the original iMac or whatever it might be. So I've got a box of about half a dozen or more drives, and I need to be able to sit down and see if I can plug it into a system somehow, if we've got a port that will accept it, and then go from there. Is there any other
I'd
ideas?
Be willing to help you try it out.
Well, thank you, Carl. Can I contact you somehow?
You guys can do it in the chat. You can have a direct message between just the two of you if you open your chat up there.
Yeah, you can send messages to individuals as opposed to the group.
Yeah. I have not used Zoom for a very long time.
It's go a down to the that bottom. Says chat.
Yeah.
They keep messing with it anyway.
Yeah, if you open chat up and then look at the bottom of the chat column.
I'm looking for chat. Here okay. It is, chat, alt plus H. I'm using a Windows machine. I don't want to sully my MacBook with the Zoom stuff.
Well, I just sent you my home phone.
Oh, got it. Thank you. Ends in 37.
Yep.
Okay, I'll just make a note of that, Cal. And I'll contact you maybe tomorrow if that's okay.
That's fine.
I
will be busy during the afternoon. Anytime in the morning should work.
Okay. Will do. Got it. Okay. Thank you for that.
Well, hopefully that'll work for you.
Yes. And anyone else got any suggestions or ideas?
I think your best bet to go with Carl, but then you got to figure out how you're going to connect that thing.
Yes, I fear it might even need to be swapped the drive into the drive with 7600.
Yeah, we can do that. I've actually got a spare 9600 too.
Oh, okay. Well, something like that will work, because I think the iMac that I had, I bought the iMac in on the 15th of August, 1998, which was when the Bondi Blue was first released, or one of the very, very first customers. And that one, I think, still operated OS 8. I'm not sure it came out. It was ever upgraded to OS 10.
That would have been 8.6, Richard, because I had the very same machine.
Okay.
And that would have been an IDE connection. So, Carl, if you have an IDE slot in one of those 9600s, then Richard's drive should just plug right in. Any older drives that he has that are SCSI, Richard, I'm not certain if the 9600 also has a slot where you could place a SCSI drive.
It has a SCSI capability.
Okay, good. In that case, I think the computer you've got should be saving Richard's bacon very nicely.
All right. Well, thank you, John. Yes, this stuff goes back a long way. I've got pretty much everything from 2004 onwards, because I got a one of the original flat panel iMacs, with the gooseneck, back about then.
Yeah, the G4.
And everything
iMac.
Since. Sorry?
The G4 iMac, yes.
Yeah. And that was. After that, I've got all the everything I think I have, images, documents, mail, and everything else. But before that, for about well, the 8 years before that, it's in lost country. I don't know where. The first computer I got when I arrived in the States was the Power Computing machine. Claire invited me to get that one because it was better value than the Macs that were going at the time. You might remember Power Computing lasted for about 2 years before Apple took back the operating system. And so that's the sort of things I'm looking for. I have various items on that, and I'm trying to recover those.
Richard, I have a question about there's two issues involved. Well, three. One would be the physical connection, SCSI, IDE, what have you. The other would be the file formats in which the drives are formatted. And then the other one would be document compatibility. Now, is there going to be a problem with you're trying to recover something using some documents that you created using a program that no longer exists? Because if that's the case, that's going to be a tough nut to crack.
I expect so. It's not so much documents. I was told that the power, what do you call it, computer solutions, that images pretty much retain their format and everything. But yes, as you say, documents might be terribly garbled. You may get the actual text right, but you won't have the formatting in some of the cases like that too. And it'd be a matter of scrolling through vast dump of text and then looking for blocks of documents. But that's not so critical. It's the images I'm looking for, but I'll take what I can get if I can find something.
What device would have been used to create the images? Just like a digital camera? Okay.
Remember we had the first digital cameras back about that time. Clunky things they were, and other things might have been scanned in somehow. So yes, there'll be a variety of JPEGs and you name it, around the place. Again, we don't know. It's sifting through the dirt in a lot of ways.
My guess is that most of the images you've got are in JPEG format, and those should be a slam dunk. Be able to, unless the file, unless you're dealing with a particular image whose copy of the file that's on the hard drive is corrupted, all right. Unless you're dealing with something like that, you should be able to get those things back. If the files are intact and if the format is JPEG, which is still widely recognized, then you and/or Carl should be able to recover those very nicely.
Well, thank you if we can. I'll get in touch with Carl tomorrow or in a future day or so, and then I might be able to get back to you next month with reports on success or otherwise. But if anyone has any ideas or suggestions where I might be able to go, I'd certainly be happy to hear them. I've still got a full Mac environment. I've got a MacBook, iPads, iPhone 15, you name it, Apple Watch. But I'm the old stuff is having trouble. I did get from old world out of world computing a couple of different drive mounts that you can click a raw drive into and get some of the information from it. But again, most of those came up saying I can't read this because the format was so arcane as far as the that system was
Yeah,
concerned.
and that's a matter of the file system, not the files themselves.
Yes, that would be the formatting of the drive and so on. So, yeah, well, look, I'll give Carl a go with it and see where we go from there. And who knows, might be a happy camper in another few weeks or so.
Okay. Can
That's
I
about
ask
as
a
much as I've
question?
got. And unless there are any consultants that anyone, is Bob McGee still around?
This is Doug.
No idea. I haven't seen him for ages and ages.
McGee. No. This is Doug Smith. Can I ask a question? I can't get the video to work, so that you just see my name on there. But I have a PowerBook, titanium PowerBook. Are you familiar with those way back?
Well, titanium PowerBook G4, yes.
And would that work?
You'd have to get an external case to put the drives in, I think, but it should might be able to read them.
You should. You'd have a FireWire 400 port coming out of the back of that. If you have, if Richard has, Richard said he'd been getting some connectors from Otherworld Computing. Richard, if any of those that you have are FireWire 400 male end, that should plug into that computer that Doug's got.
Yes, I have a another World Computing case that you can put a drive into. When I bought them, you know, you bought it just the mounting thing, and it had all the power and the connections that came off it, but you just slammed your drive inside it somehow.
Right. So you have a dock. You're saying you have a dock.
Yes, I do.
And does that dock have USB and a FireWire 400?
I can't recall. I'll have a look, but see.
And does that dock work
here
with,
is a,
with the drive
what's
you want to
look
put
like
in?
There?
Ooh.
Am I holding it the right way around?
That's USB and
there's an on-off switch of power thing in it. And
400.
Yes,
that's 100 times two. You've got it.
Right.
Okay, that's an enclosure. That's not a, I don't call that a dock.
No, that's an enclosure, this thing here. The other things are these things here.
I have something to say about that enclosure you just showed. Hi, Richard.
This is a dock.
Yeah, that's a dock.
A slot,
that, I call
and
that
it's got
the dock.
USB out. But things weren't taken very well to that. And then there's this gadget, which is a
right
universal drive adapter.
Actually, that's for further back before they had SATA, I think.
Yeah. But
that's so your drive may not be SATA, which might require what you're showing now.
Yeah. Yeah, so I've got all the hardware. It should be enough. It's just a matter of finding someone who's got the operating system that it be able to feed into.
Well, the TIEBOOK has OS 9, and it has OS 10 both in it.
That ought to work.
Yeah. Well. Let me start with
Doug. Why don't you change numbers too?
I can get in touch with Doug later on.
Because we need
maybe.
To move on, okay?
And then I'll leave it for that because I'm taking too much time at the moment for everyone. Thanks very much for your help.
You might send me an email separately, away from the taking up time at the meeting, and because I never throw away a Mac, and I don't know if they all work anymore, but I've got a Kanga, I've got a 9600, I've got a Quadra. I've got various models of G4s, including the TIEBOOK. And I got about 10 or 12, 14 max.
Okay, again, exchange numbers, please, because we need to move on. Okay?
Okay, mine is 314.
Well, do it. Why don't you do it through the direct chat?
In the chat. Don't
do it how?
In the chat.
Chat, open your chat window. Chat's at the bottom of Zoom there. And then at the bottom of the chat window, select each other's name. That way it's a direct message to each other.
Yeah.
Oh, chat. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Glenn, it's time for you to do your goodies.
Okay. Let me pull these up. Wait a minute. Let's try this again.
Okay. Who am I sending this to?
Richards.
Richard, yeah. Oh, hang on.
All right. Can you guys all see that?
Yep.
All right. So my goodies for September. So we'll start with this since we just had the Big Apple event. There was a 14-year-old, a kid named Lorenzo from Italy, that created a bogus invite. And he said he did this in about 10 minutes. You can see his little thing that he set up there. And he sent the image to a well-known Apple leaker. And then he watched as it kind of spread like wildfire out on the internet in the Apple rumor mill. And, you know, he says, I feel like leaks can be boring sometimes, so I want to spice it up, he told Cult of Mac in a direct message, maybe by putting more effort into making a good concept next time. But anyway, I thought this was kind of funny because, like, now the world is, like, all fired up. And that was the rumors I remember seeing, that it was originally going to be on September 10th. And, you know, this might have actually started with this kid in Italy who created this thing.
Yeah.
All right. And there you can see his, this was his handle there. And he said, basically he just, you know, went in there and he just created this thing. And, and he said he was using Figma and he used AI generated texture, and it took him 10 minutes to do this thing, and voila, it's all over the world. All right. So you can see an ex user named Science Girl. And so she posted an interesting video. She was at the Olympics showing just how good the zoom is on the iPhone 15 Pro Max. And so this video is pretty impressive. And I'll show this to you. So this is the 100-meter dash she's taken a video of. You can see how far away that she was sitting when she did this. And I'll play that again. You look at the quality of this. Look where she's sitting. Oop, I didn't mean to do that. Look at the quality of the video. You know, it's pretty darn good video considering, you know, she was probably, you know, a couple hundred meters away at least from that. All right. My next item is kind of an interesting tidbit I came across. HDMI cables can be used to spy on computer screens. So I don't know how often you guys use an HDMI cable to connect your computers, but to quote this, it says, in a surprising development that may concern Apple users, computer security researchers, from Uruguay have discovered a method to reconstruct screen content by intercepting electromagnetic emissions from HDMI cables. The bad news is the HDMI cable security threat could potentially impact all devices using HDMI, including Apple gear. The good news is that it's not easy to do, so individual users aren't likely to be targets, but companies and governments might be. And so it's just interesting that, you know, there could be a weakness exploited through HDMI cables. And, you know, depending on what device you're using, you see HDMI cables on a lot of your computers now. So am I too worried about it? No, but, you know, it's just something out there that, you know, who knows, could be a potential problem in the future. So this is kind of, I thought was interesting. A former Apple employee warns about updating iOS 18 if you have an older phone. And I would take this with a grain of salt, but I think this goes with any new systems with older phones. Tyler Morgan, a former Apple sales specialist who now helps other iPhone users and people interested in Apple products, has shared his thoughts about Apple's upcoming software update. While everyone is waiting for iOS 18, it's one of the biggest software updates we had in years. Morgan warns people that iOS 18 might not be the right option for your phone. It may end up slowing down your phone. And, you know, the big thing is because of the whole Apple Intelligence stuff, which, first of all, that's only, you're only going to get the full benefit of the Apple Intelligence If you have an i15 Pro, Pro Max, or an iPhone 16 model, but some of the iPhone 18 stuff, it's, you know, the system is getting more and more powerful as we go through each of these systems. And so while you can get it to work on recent iPhones, you know, if you're running, you know, a 10 or 11 or 12, you could notice that your phone's not going to, you know, work as optimally with it, is what he's saying. You know, he says if he had an iPhone 10 or older, not, I mean, my words say molder, it shouldn't say molder, it should say older. He actually recommends not using it. You know, I think I would at least try it, but he says, while you can still install iOS 18, the software update will be too demanding for older iPhones. This could result in your iPhone consuming more battery life and over time permanently damaging the battery. So, you know, take that for what it's worth. You know, whether you want to update to iOS 18 or not here in the near future. All right. Our next thing is some AirPods features. And I don't know how many of you are AirPods users. I love mine. I use them, gosh, probably every day. So I've got this short little video about some little AirPods features you may not know about.
Today, I'm going to show you five secret features you didn't know about your AirPods. Now, who here hasn't shared a song with a close friend or a potted plant by splitting a pair of earbuds? Well, if you each have your own pair of AirPods or any of these Beats headphones, you can actually output from one iPhone to both simultaneously. So you don't have to split a single pair, you can each have the full stereo set. Whether you're listening to music or watching a video, you want to tap this AirPlay button right here. Then you'll tap Share Audio, and you want to make sure the other pair of headphones are nearby, and then tap Share Audio again. Your friend might have to tap Join on their iPhone. Then you just check the other box, and it'll start playing to both simultaneously. You can set different volume levels too. Just open Control Center and tap and hold on this slider here, and you'll see two different volume sliders, one for each pair. This is really handy if you ever want to deafen your friends. Number two, you can use your AirPods to spy on people. So there's a feature for accessibility called Live Listen. It takes the microphone from the AirPods and boosts it through the speakers to help people who are hard of hearing, kind of like a hearing aid. But AirPods have a really long range. So say people are having a conversation in a room and you leave your AirPods just inconspicuously on a bookshelf somewhere. Well, you can be in the next room over and you might just happen to hear what they're talking about. So you want to go to Settings, Control Center, and add the hearing button. Then when you go to Control Center again, tap on that button and turn on Live Listen. Just turn it off when you're done. Number three, so your AirPods have all these controls for activating Siri, pausing, going to the next track, going backwards. On newer AirPods, you do this by clicking on the stem, and on older AirPods, you do this by slapping your ear. Well, you can actually customize what they do, and you can have different controls for your left and your right. With your AirPods connected, go to Settings, AirPods, and then under left or right, you can pick from a few different actions. Siri, play, pause, next track, previous track, or you can just turn it off. Number four. So if you have AirPods Pro, you already know that you can switch between noise cancellation and transparency mode by clicking and holding on the stem. But did you know you can also do it from the Apple Watch? From the now playing screen, you tap the AirPlay icon in the bottom corner, and you can just easily pick from the menu. This is really convenient if you're one of those people with a cellular Apple Watch, then you go for a run, leaving your phone at home, and there's no guesswork. You can just pick from a menu and know that you're in transparency mode when you're trying to cross the street, and know that you're in isolation mode when you're on the trail. Number five, in the same vein, if you're exercising and you don't want to be distracted every time a text comes in, you can have Siri announce all of your incoming phone calls and read you all your notifications. Just go to Settings, Phone, Announce Phone Calls, and set it to Headphones Only. Next, you want to go back and scroll up to Notifications, tap Announce Notifications, and turn it on. That way you won't miss an important notification while you're working out. Before you go, there's one more thing. The Cult of Mac store has a bunch of AirPod accessories you can check out. Cases, ear hooks, headphone jack adapters, a special watch band that keeps them in
place. All right, I'm going to stop him there, but just some cool little features of your AirPods. And obviously we're going to be talking more about AirPods because those were featured heavily yesterday.
Today,
All right, my next little item. There's an app called Camo for macOS. And so Camo was originally designed to allow, if you had an iPhone or if you're an Android user, to, you know, use your phone as a webcam, a better webcam than what comes on your computer. Of course, we all know that in, you know, the last couple of years, you don't need an app to do this because of the functionality of iOS. But the versions of this app for the Mac, it actually, you can better control the video from the built-in camera, whether you're using your camera on your Mac or even the camera on your phone to really control the video. And it's got quite a bit of control. And so as it says here, Camo Studio gives you full control of your video, letting you adjust lenses, exposure, colors, contrasts, and more. It lets you zoom, crop, and focus your image precisely how you want it. Apply cinematic styling and color grading to your video with 18 bespoke filters, including support for custom Cube 3DL and LUT files. So I have a bigger version that I took a picture of this on my desktop, and you can see there's quite a bit of controls. Now, there is a free version of this, but you can see certain things are grayed out. You have to get the pro version in order to have full functionality of some of these things. But you can see that, you know, there's quite a bit of things, like even the little tag there, like, you know, with my name and my information. If you look on the left-hand side where it says overlays and watermarks, they have templates, and there's different places for your name or how you want to display it. You can control video. So it's kind of cool functionality for, you know, how the video is on your, you know, video conferencing. And like I said, there's a free version. It does some nice things. And if you want the pro version for, you know, full functionality, it's $49.99 per year, but you can also buy a lifetime license for $99.99. So, you know, if you like it, that would make much more sense to me. Okay, the next product I want to mention to you is the KeySmart Smart Card. KeySmart makes some cool products. I've actually used a KeySmart keychain for years now to better organize my keys. And so they've got this little tracker. And so while I know a lot of people have the, you know, the Apple AirTags and use those, I love this little thing because it's a credit card. You can just put it right in your wallet, and it allows you to track your, you know, your wallet. You also notice that there's a hole on the right side there for like a lanyard, if you want to connect it to a lanyard for something. And it says here, it works with the Apple Find My app, located nearby or through the Apple network. Get notified when you leave it behind and use lost mode to help retrieve it. At less than 2 millimeters thick, it's ultra slim and fits easily in your wallet. As I said, it has a lanyard slot for IDs. It sports wireless charging, and it'll last up to 5 months on a single charge. It also has a waterproof rating on there. And so it's a nice little thing. I like that little slim feature versus like the Apple AirTags. I'm not sure I really have liked the form of the actual AirTag itself.
Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to set up the KeySmart card, how to charge it, how to connect it to your phone, and how to reset it if you need to. The first thing we have to do is make sure that the KeySmart card is fully charged. Now, in order to charge the KeySmart card, you need a wireless charger like this one. It's important to note that in order to charge the KeySmart card, you need to have it in the correct position on the wireless charger. For the KeySmart card, you have to make sure that the KeySmart logo is facing up. Now, watch this. When I put it down, facing down, it is not charging at all. But when I have it facing up, like so, this red light pops up. That means it's charging. As you can see, I have the KeySmart card charging on this wireless charger, and you can tell that it's charging because it has this red light indicator telling you that it is charging. Now, when this turns green, that means you have a full charge. So you should know that it takes usually about an hour to charge the KeySmart card, so just leave it on there until you see this red light turn green. Now that the light is green, that means it's fully charged and you're ready to connect it. Now, in order to connect your KeySmart card, there's a little icon right here, as you can see, and you're gonna push 5 times, and on the 5th push, you're gonna hold it until you hear it make a little song. And it's gonna go like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hold. Now it's ready to pair with your phone. So open the Apple Find My app, and then right here it says devices, push this little plus sign right here, add other items searching, and you wait for it to, the KeySmart card is ready to connect, push connect, enter name. I'm gonna put wallet. Choose an emoji, why not? I'm gonna do this one because it's nice and wacky. Now you just wait for it to finish setup, and now it is officially connected, and as you can see right here, it's with me, and I can play the sound as well. Kind of cool. And you can even do directions to help you find it. Now, let's say for any reason
you— All right, I'm going to stop it there.
Yeah.
But anyway, I like kind of just that flat card versus the AirTag, the just my personal preference. And you can see here, KeySmart makes some really cool stuff. Like I said, I've had one of these keychains for years. Love it because I never have to worry about my keys getting tangled up. And you can also get ones that have other little devices on there. I had one at one time. I had a little USB drive on there. But you can see here that like the KeySmart, you know, iPro, for instance, you can use that with Find My as well. So if you're trying to figure out where your keys went. So anyway, KeySmart makes some nice products.
Yeah.
Another cool product I came across, it's the Sleeper Bone Conduction Pillow Speaker. And I thought this was kind of cool. So you can see what the device looks like and you put it on your under your pillow. And I'll read what it says here. Perfect for sleeping. The sleeper speaker is designed to be your sleep companion. Place it under the pillow for the most gentle yet personalized way to experience sound as you get into your cozy zone. Listen to your favorite audiobook, podcast, music, white noise, and more without disturbing your partner simply through your pillow. So the way it works, and I don't own one, but supposedly if you're laying there on that pillow, you're the only one that can hear that. So if somebody's laying next to you in bed, they can't hear it. It uses bone conduction. Most often the sound is heard through air conduction. This is when the sound waves travel through the air to our eardrums, causing them to vibrate. The vibrations from the eardrums are then received by the bone in the inner ear called the cochlea to ultimately let our brain process this vibration as sound. With bone conduction, eardrum step is bypassed. It delivers vibrations directly to the bone in the inner ear to deliver sound. With the sleeper speaker placed under the pillow, you can rest comfortably without wearing a device and still hear your favorite sound. It will free you from any soreness or pain experienced from wearing earbuds over an extended period of time. Measuring at 0.4 inches thin, the sleeper speaker will disappear between your bed and pillow, so all you feel is nothing but comfort. And you can use it two ways. You can wirelessly pair it and use it coming from your phone, or there's a little SD card slot in it that you, and that's not included, but you can, you know, put stuff on there, you know, before you use it. And it also has a timer option on there, a 1 hour timer that you can play it and then it'll go off. So it costs, by the way, $49.99, but I noticed right now that on the Cult of Max store, they had it for $39.99. So I thought if you're somebody that likes to listen to something, you know, when you go to sleep at night, but you don't want to disturb your partner and you don't want to have to wear headphones, this seemed like it would be an ideal product. And my last one here I have, it's called The Right One, therightone.com. So sometimes people will lose one of their earbuds, not both, or maybe you lose the case or something. And Apple, to replace that stuff, it's pretty expensive. And so they have this company I recently heard about, and they will sell you just one earbud or just a charging case or whatever you need at a time. And so what they do is they're basically reconditioned genuine Apple Beats or Samsung products they sell. And so, they guarantee that they work and everything, but it's definitely cheaper than what you would pay if you had to go through Apple for this. And I'm sure it's pretty aggravating if you lose just one earbud. All right. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot I had one other thing. We all remember Johnny Ive, the designer, famous designer from Apple. Well, he's still alive and designing stuff. And so if you wonder what happened to him, well, he has his own design firm called Love From. And so the latest thing that he designed, he's working, there is an Italian outdoor luxury clothing brand called Moncler. And he's been working with them to redesign the coat button. And so the product specifically that the Johnny Ive and Moncler are working on is this modular jacket, kind of cover poncho, heavier jacket on top of it. And what he created is a magnetic button that attaches to the base layer. When they come together, they just automatically attach. And as you can see, they use some interesting pastel colors. And so that's the button right there. You can see a picture of it. And basically what happens is when they get in proximity, it's a pretty powerful magnet. And I saw a video of this where, they just kind of came together. It was just wham, came right together. You could drop the whole coat on it. And every one of those grabbed the right magnet. It's pretty interesting that it did it. And I watched a demonstration of it. It's not actually for sale yet. It'll go on sale September 24th. But I would tell you, if that looks interesting to you, or you wanted to buy a jacket from Moncler or their clothing, the old adage, if you have to ask how expensive it is, then you probably can't afford it. And their stuff is expensive. Their jackets routinely sell on the thousands of dollars. So anyway, I just happened to come across this, and I was like, oh, Johnny Ive, I wonder what he's up to these days. And there you go. Design, still trying to redesign and come up with the perfect products.
When, of all things, is somebody going to design a replacement for the necktie?
Well, I would say don't wear it.
Hey, Glenn, I got something too. I worked for Mercy Hospital, and I did a lot of repairs on what they called a pillow speaker.
Yeah.
Communication device that you would use to call the nurse also had the TV audio on it.
Right.
And they would encourage people to put it underneath their pillow so they wouldn't disturb their roommate. So it's just a homage to your pillow speaker.
I think it's a great idea because, there are a lot of people who, maybe they just want to fall asleep to some white noise or, an audio book or something. I know somebody who has, tinnitus in the ear and they can't sleep when it's quiet because then they're hearing all this stuff in their ear. They need something. And that way you're not having to actually wear headphones, which aren't very comfortable when you're laying down, and you're not disturbing whoever might be laying next to you. I came across some interesting products, and I know since we're going to be talking about new Apple stuff, I thought, well, let's talk about some products today. I'd kind of go in that direction with my goodies this month.
Okay.
Glenn, you said you had some things you wanted to point out to the group about iOS 18 or what?
Well, I was just saying to Ron, as we get into looking at some of the new stuff, and I thought, there was some real substance at yesterday's keynote. By the way, how many of you saw the keynote yesterday?
Didn't see it.
Okay, a few, some, okay. Well, I just was thinking in my head, and I started just make a little list of What were the things just immediately jumped out and wowed me? And what are the things that I thought weren't really clear and I wonder about? The stuff that wowed me, first of all, I felt like they were doing a lot more with software that can help improve your existing device. And Apple hasn't always been real friendly with that kind of thing. You know, oh, you want these features? Well, go buy our newest, you know, and latest and greatest gear. And so I thought it was kind of cool that, you know, you're going to get some benefits from, you know, without going and having to buy new gear for some of this stuff. The camera control button on the iPhone, I think, is really cool. And we'll look at that. That was cool. I was really, really impressed when they were talking about the AirPods. Well, specifically the AirPod Pro 2s and how they are literally getting FDA approval for those to become legitimate hearing aids. And there's a hearing test that you can do. And when you do the hearing test, that they will keep that information. And now whenever you're listening to music or a movie or whatever, they will change, they'll tweak your settings to help improve the audio based on your hearing test.
Yeah,
so
you have to take the test first. Yeah.
I thought this was really, really cool. You know, I also thought some of the water workout stuff they were doing that they're adding is pretty cool. I don't know if you saw where if you're rowing, they've got a little thing that'll be on, you know, on your watch here and it'll show you directions. So if you've got a route planned and you're just, you know, paddling along, you can look at, you know, look down at your watch and see that arrow so, to know if you're, you know, getting off track or not. I thought, wow, that's really cool. The sleep apnea detection, another health thing that the FDA is going to be approving where the watch can, you know, sense that, I think is a real, real cool feature. Although I'm not sure that does away with an actual sleep study, because if you figure out on your watch that you have sleep apnea, well, now you're going to go see a doctor and they're going to say, well, we need to do a sleep study because, you know, if we're going to get insurance to cover your sleep machine, they're not going to take for granted what the watch says. So, but I thought it was kind of a cool feature. Speaking of the watch, the built-in speakers on the 10, I thought it was a cool idea, you know, because you always have had to have headphones, but if I just want to listen to something on my watch here, you know, I thought, oh, well, that's a great, I thought they should do that for a while. So anyway, so that stuff jumped out at me that I was like, wow, those are cool features. I also had a list of four or five things that I'm like, well, I need more information on this. The first thing is with that little camera control button they're adding, they're saying that it's got a two-stage shutter. You know, if you press it gentle, you get camera information. If you press it hard, that actually can, you know, you can hold the focus. So when you take the picture, and I thought the focus hold was really cool. So if your subject's moving, it'll focus just on them. But, you know, is this going to be just for the Pro models? It sounded like that, but I'm not sure. Is this going to be available right away or is this something later? They were a little vague on that. I don't remember. Did anybody hear? I had to go look it up later. I don't remember hearing during their entire presentation them saying when iOS 18 would be released. I had to go out and find that, and it's next Monday, by the way, the 18th.
Yeah, I saw that in a article today.
Yeah, I was shocked that they didn't have that in their presentation. You would have thought that would have been something. And by the way, to go along with that, Apple Intelligence is not going to drop immediately with iOS 18. That's going to come with 18.1. So, you know, we're probably going to have to wait a month or two to see the actual Apple Intelligence stuff that we've all been waiting for. You know, one of the things they mentioned about that sleep apnea function, they list the Apple Watch 9, the Apple Watch 10, and the Ultra 2. Well, like, for instance, I've got an Ultra, the first Ultra, the original. And I'm curious, does it not work with that? It's interesting that it would work with the Apple Watch 9 and the Ultra 2, but not the Ultra. And I'm guessing it has something to do with the chip in there, but I'm curious if they overlooked that or if that's really true. Also, I'm curious that, I don't know, do any of you have Ultras? I know John has one. Anybody else have an Ultra? Okay. It's got a damn loud speaker in this thing. Because there is like a little siren thing in here if you need it for an emergency. And I immediately tested that thing out and it's loud. So I'm curious, this being able to use the speaker function in the Watch 10, is that going to be available for the Ultras with their speakers? I didn't hear anything about that. And then finally, one other little thing is in Watch OS 11 coming out, there the Translate app on there. I'm curious how this is going to work because they really didn't talk about Watch OS 11, but supposedly I saw where if you're in a foreign country and somebody is speaking a foreign language, it will actually take the Translate app and jump it up on your smart stack. So it's available right there to translate. And they didn't really explain too much about that. So I'm curious to learn a lot more about that, how that's functionality is going to work. So anyway, those are the things that kind of just jumped out at me from yesterday.
Okay. Some of that probably will be when it actually drops, then you'll find information about it because it's in beta now. And some of that maybe is not functioning yet.
The shocker to me was the iOS 18 thing. I can't believe they didn't say, and this will be available, they always do that. And I was like, we got it done. I'm like, they didn't even mention like when that's coming out.
Yeah, I know. I walked through the presentation a couple of times. I thought, no, you're right. I never saw it there ever.
In their defense, they might, when they recorded this, they might not have known because there was still a lot of development work left ahead.
That's true. But like I had to go hunt for that. You think Apple would want people to know when that's dropping so that people will, they want people to download that and adapt to it. So I'm okay. But that's a good point, John.
Glenn, did you hear, I did not, did you hear a date, a predicted date for the availability of that update that would allow the AirPods Pro 2 to be used as a hearing aid? They just said it's what? Coming, waiting on FDA approval. I did not hear a date. Did you hear
it?
A date?
It was just
waiting no. fall. They just said later this fall. So yeah. I'm
waiting for approval.
Yeah, in my mind, we're probably looking at by the end of the year would be my guess. But
well, they will have had to submit a ton of data to the FDA to get that approval, and sure. For them to be announcing this even now means that they've been working on this for a long time, because they've got to submit data, they've got to get feedback, and then they have to resubmit and so on. And that process takes there are several steps in that process. And for them to say that they're going to get it, or it sounds like it means they've already done a ton of work, and they are all they're probably just waiting for the last, the last final sign off from the FDA commissioners to get that approved.
Of course, we all know how well and how quickly federal bureaucracy works.
Well, no, I'm saying it works slowly, which means my basic point is they've been at this for a long time.
Because I would agree, John.
Slowly.
I think you're
correct. The FDA works slowly. Eventually they will come around and they will, they'll give you a thumbs up or a thumbs down. And the point I'm making is Apple has been at this for a long time because they know that those developments, that those approvals take a long time. And that means they have submitted a ton of data. So that, I guess I'm saying that I'm hoping that it comes out soon. If for them to even mention, to out where the world can hear them, that they're expecting it to be approved, it means that they've done a lot of work. They've spent a lot of money. My guess is that they're going to get the approval. I'm just waiting. I can't wait for that to happen. For the sake of my dear wife, who would love to be able to use her AirPods Pro as a hearing device, as a hearing aid.
John, make sure, though, if you're going to get that, make sure you get the 2s. It's not the original AirPod Pro. It's the AirPod Pro 2.
Yeah, we've got the 2, magnetic charging and the USB-C connection, the whole works.
Yeah.
Can I say something about the Apple Watch? Sure. We saw something we used Aetna for our thing, and they mentioned you can get an exercise tracking watch, and they mentioned like the Apple Watch. I don't know which one they'll approve and how much they'll give us. But
I was
now
going to
my
say, how
wife's
much are they
saying
willing to give you for it?
they didn't say. We could call them, but I'm just saying we saw that in a recent blurb, you know, thing of the, oh, well, my wife's saying, okay, maybe I'll get one. And she's looking at the 10.
You know, Dave, I've heard though that those companies are going to be kind of, and I don't know if this is true or not. I just heard this that these health companies are going to be sort of cutting back on some of the devices that because people are spending a ton of money on this stuff. Like I know that my
but they always bill the government for more than what they pay you give you. If you get a $500, a $300 device, they have charged the government $450.
This summer, we were taking my son to Top Golf because he's really gotten into golf and likes to hit balls. And my in-laws would come along and they would always get out the credit card and pay for it. And say, oh yeah, our insurance pays for this. You know, we get this allotment, you know, for exercise and stuff. And so they were paying. And it's like between the devices and all this other stuff, I've heard they might start kind of, you know, tightening that up a little bit.
Yeah, they'll pay for golf, but they won't pay for the cart.
Yeah.
I know that one.
Okay, guys, then I put together a kind of a presentation or sort of presentation of the Apple experience, and it was like an hour and 40 minutes long, and some of this I'm going to read to you because it's right off the actual video, and it's going to sound like I'm an Apple salesman, but that's the key.
Well, wait, then you have to do this.
Yeah.
Well, I've got to read it off this paper, so that's not going to help, but at least I don't. Okay, well, let's see if I can figure out. Share. Oh, okay, here we go.
Ron, very quickly before you start, could I ask everybody who is not speaking to please mute? Because every once in a while, if somebody just has the slightest little background noise, they interrupt whoever's presenting. And I will now do that for myself.
Okie doke. Okay, do you see it's glow time?
Yes.
Okay. God damn fucking... I can't somehow it wants to climb up on this counter right now. Okay. So this was, I'm not even sure, by the way, does anybody think what glow time meant? I have no idea what it meant. But anyway.
It's a play on words for it's go time.
I guess, but glow, what's the glow? Anyway, there were actually several things that there's two Apple Watch Series 10 and Apple Watch Ultra 2. There's AirPods 4, AirPods Max, and AirPods Pro 2, and then iPhone 16 and iPhone 16 Pro. So this is the Apple Watch Series 10 has the powerful S10 SIP and a breakthrough sleep apnea feature. It's our fastest charging watch yet with all day 18-hour battery life, and new depth and water temperature sensors make it great for water activities. Notice the prices are $399 for the GPS and $49 for the GPS and cellular on the Apple Watch Series 10. Then you have the Apple Watch Ultra 2, and it comes in this black color, actually new, I suppose. This Apple Watch Ultra 2 is our most rugged and capable Apple Watch with a durable titanium case and sapphire front crystal, now in a stunning black with a matching Milanese loop. Actually,
hey,
I like the Milanese loop, mine. I'm sorry, what?
Oh, I was just going to say, yeah, I agree. I think that the new band, the Milanese loop band, looked pretty nice.
Yeah, it does.
That Tides app that they have there, I thought was pretty cool. If you're, you know, doing stuff around the ocean and everything, I thought that was a cool little app to use.
Question: is the blood oxygen feature still blocked on the Apple Watch in the USA?
Yeah, there's a company that holds patent or something and hasn't allowed Apple to use it. Hey, I'm sorry, what?
I would say I saw a little blurb though on Apple's website about it, if you look and there's sort of little fine print on the bottom, there are little footnotes. It says something about the blood oxygen stuff, and you know, this isn't a substitute for, you know, actual medical, professional medical data and stuff like that. So you might still be able to use it. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. Was it available for an earlier watch, I suppose? Anyway, the Ultra 2 is going to be $799 with GPS and cellular.
I like the options. I swim for exercise, and I like the fact that that's you can wear it in the water and it helps you track your workout. I just think it's great.
And if you go scuba diving, you can actually track how far down you go.
Well, I like swimming on the top. I mean, I went through the certification for scuba, but I'm like, that's all right. I like working on the surface, and I swam outside at Heman Pool all summer. It was great.
By the way, that watch would
really be nice.
The depth reading on the watch will take effect right away. Like, I've got a fairly large aquarium, and when I've got my hand down in the aquarium, even, you know, just a foot down, it'll start registering the depth on my watch.
Okay.
This is the AirPods. Let's see. These models are best open air AirPods that we've ever built, with game-changing audio performance, powered by advanced machine learning that enables personalized spatial audio and active noise cancellation with voice isolation.
By the way, if you don't own the AirPod Pros, that's probably my favorite feature on them, has been the noise cancellation. I love that when I'm doing, you know, yard work and stuff. So it's great that they're bringing this to the regular AirPods now.
Yeah, that's true. Notice the $129 for the AirPods 4, and with the active noise cancellation, it's $179. AirPods Max, I think they're the same price as they are, but they have several colors. And it says it's in beautiful new colors: midnight, blue, purple, orange, and starlight, along with a USB-C, and the price is still $549. By the way, notice everything that Apple mentioned has USB-C now. So
I think that's because Europe cracked the whip.
Yep, that's because the EU.
Well, you're right, that's partly that.
Well, it's they don't want to lose a market of 400 million people.
AirPods Pro 2 says delivering the world's first all-in-one experience with active hearing protection and critical grade hearing test. A clinical grade, I'm sorry. And an easy to use professional grade hearing aid. I didn't see anything like John was asking about when that will be, but of course there'll probably be active updates to the AirPods 2.
By the way, that hearing test I heard is actually a commonly used testing method by, you know, audiologists and doctors and stuff. I'm not an expert with that, but that's what I was hearing, that this isn't just some weird Apple fly-by-night thing. They're using a pretty standard testing procedure.
Right.
If I can just add to that, I have a hearing aid here because my surgery took out the whole hearing on my right side of my face, and that was my good ear. I've now had to pay $3,500 for a little hearing aid that fits in here. That's a game changer for the from Apple, because if I can get an iPod, just one, because all I need is one. This doesn't. I've lost my ear here, but the price will be low enough, and What you're paying for in a $3,000 hearing aid is the regular returns to an audiologist who checks your frequencies, your hearing, and does all those testing. That's now included with this app for it, and that's going to really shake up the industry because I'll be quite happy to go for a single AirPod to do all this, and I'll be very happy because it does all the other things that that it'll do as well. So I'm all on board on that. I'm very pleased to see it.
I agree with you.
Love for that, Richard.
There's also the other thing, real quick. I know some people don't like to wear a hearing aid. It's more, kind of a vanity thing. And I think for some people to be just more natural, oh, I've just got a headphone in on one ear, or something like that.
Okay, iPhone 16, that's the colors that they come in. Let's see, is it 15? There's iPhone 16 with incredible camera experiences, including the 4-megapixel fusion camera, macro and spatial capture, deep customization abilities with the action button and iOS 18, and built for Apple intelligence from the ground up with A18 chip. Camera control that enables visual intelligence and a big boost, in battery life.
Hey, Ron.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if anybody else noticed, but over the last, I don't remember when Apple introduced the Pro models, how many generations that's been now, but there has been a real difference between the Pro models and the regular models in terms of what the camera could do. And one thing I noticed, I don't know if anybody else noticed this, that they are giving more power to the non-Pro model cameras this generation. Like, that the 16 can do spatial, photo and video, for instance. And, just some of the functionality of it, like with the camera control stuff, because over the last few generations, that would have been stuff that they would have only put on the Pro models.
No, you're right.
But they added a lot more to the Pro models this time.
Yeah.
I mean, it's really Pro.
The iPhone 16 is $799, and the 16 Plus is $899. Of course, those are 128 gigabytes. It goes up if you have a larger storage space. The iPhone 16 Pro with Apple Intelligence, it has the A18 Pro chip also. A beautiful titanium design, larger displays, camera control, and innovative features across photo, video, and audio. This is a huge step forward. Of course, that's all the stuff that I typed from the Apple presentation.
Mm-hmm.
Notice 16 Pro is $999, and the iPhone 16 Pro Max is $1,199 with a larger storage space.
By the way, it's some pretty impressive video resolution that the Pro models can take.
Oh yeah, they showed about it making a movie and such, and it's kind of amazing. Plus the audio too. There's their whole lineup. So they do sell the 14 and 15 yet, and the iPhone SE. There's the prices. And of course it says from, because you can trick it out a little more. And that's me. See you at the Apple Store, or online, I suppose.
Ron, we're going to see you at the Apple Store.
Actually, I have a 10RS or whatever that is. And so I'm itching to go to a 16. So exactly whether I'll just do it online or actually go to the Apple Store, I don't know. So I know I need to get a new phone.
And then, I'm
sorry.
I think the 16 is going to be a big seller. And I think part of that is because a lot of people who, don't have a 15 Pro model are going to want to be able to use the Apple Intelligence stuff. And so I think you're going to see a lot of people upgrading their phones to the 16s.
Well, to buy Apple stock,
my
right?
old Apple Watch is a five, so it doesn't run the new
Yeah.
software either. So I may have to double down for all these things.
Just curious, how many people are, is there something, how many people are thinking about buying one of the things that was shown? Okay.
So if you have Apple stock, maybe it's going to go up, you know.
They do offer rebates. I mean, if you turn yours in, I think it's 300 for mine as a 12 Pro. That's seems
My
like
10S or whatever, it showed on the website $80.
you waited too long, Ron.
Well, it serves my purpose.
Saved you
Well,
a lot.
it's better than nothing.
That's right.
I'm ready to go.
Okay, I have a one, like a 12-minute video. And let's see if I share this. Share sound. Optimize video. Okay. Can you see him?
Yes.
Okay. This is from Mac Rumors. It's a 12-minute like synopsis of all that happened in there in Apple's presentation.
Here's everything Apple just announced at today's fall iPhone event. Apple started the keynote with the announcement of the latest Apple Watch lineup, and this year we have the brand new Apple Watch Series 10. The Apple Watch Series 10 has been updated to feature its biggest display ever, and it's also the thinnest Apple Watch ever. Now, Apple says it's redesigned, but honestly, at first glance, it kind of looks the same to me. However, you'll notice that it's very rounded off, like it's very round around the corners. The display is slightly bigger than Apple Watch Ultra and is 30% larger than a Series 6. Larger displays shows more information and even makes it easier to type on. The display is up to 40% brighter when viewed at an angle thanks to the wide-angle OLED display. And there's also a new jet black color option along with a rose gold and silver aluminum. The new Series 10 is 9.7 millimeters thin and is 10% thinner than Series 9. You can also play music and podcasts directly through your speaker now for the first time, which is handy if you don't have your AirPods nearby. The new watch can also charge faster with up to 80% battery in 30 minutes. The Apple Watch Series 10 comes in a new titanium replacing stainless steel that's polished to look glossy and comes in natural gold and dark slate gray. This new lineup is powered by the S10 chip, and there are new intelligence features coming to your smart stack and translation app, but also some new health features. That's right, the Series 10 can now alert users to sleep apnea. It uses the accelerometer to monitor breathing disturbances throughout the night, and this feature will monitor over the course of 30 days and analyze whether or not you have sleep apnea, and it'll pass along that information to let you know what your next step should be. The built-in depth gauge is also present on the Series 10, and you can even monitor the temperature of the water when swimming, snorkeling, or diving. The Apple Watch Series 10 starts at $399 and $499 for the cellular model, and it's available for pre-order now and will be available on September 20th. Apple also added a new satin black Apple Watch Ultra 2, not 3. There's no update, just a new color option for the previous generation. There's also a new titanium Milanese loop for the Apple Watch Ultra. For you fancy folks out there's a new Hermes band for Apple Watch Ultra 2. It will start at $799 as usual, and pre-orders again are now with deliveries coming next Friday. Next up, we have updates to the entire AirPods lineup. The new AirPods 4 were officially announced and have been redesigned to feature a more comfortable fit and includes the H2 chip. The charging case has also been updated to feature USB-C and delivers 30 hours of battery life even in a smaller case. A secondary AirPods 4 model was also announced to feature active noise cancellation and transparency for the first time on a non-Pro AirPods. And you can easily toggle between these modes, or you can use the adaptive audio feature to let it do its thing for you. You do get conversation awareness on these new high-end AirPods 4, and you have wireless charging and a speaker on the case for Find My. AirPods 4 without ANC starts at $129 and $179 for the ANC version. And like the watches, it's also available to pre-order today, with orders coming out next week. AirPods Max finally got an update, and just as expected, it's just new colors. So you get new midnight, blue, purple, and orange, as well as a starlight option. And oh yeah, by the way, you no longer have lightning. It features a USB-C port. And that's it. Pre-orders also start today. It's still $549, and those will be shipped out next Friday. The AirPods Pro 2 also got a somewhat surprising update today, with new features centered around hearing health. For prevention, Apple is adding a new hearing protection, basically turning your AirPods into earplugs, which is really cool. It'll adjust based on whether you're playing a show or you're most likely at a show. You can now basically use these as earplugs. Apple has also added a hearing test for your iPhone and AirPods Pro to work together so that you can check your hearing and gain awareness on where you stand, and all of that data will be privately stored in the Health app. And lastly, the AirPods Pro 2 have been updated to be a clinical grade hearing aid. That's right, a clinical grade hearing aid feature has been added to the AirPods Pro 2. And so after taking the hearing test, your AirPods will automatically be transformed into this hearing aid, and it'll be precisely tailored to your hearing profile, adjusting the levels that you need to be able to hear clearly. This is also automatically applied to movies and music and phone calls while using your iPhone and AirPods together without having to adjust anything. These features will be available in a software update later this fall. You don't have to go out and buy a new AirPods Pro 2, just a software update later this year. Now, before we get into the rest of this video, I want to take a second to tell you about today's sponsor, Rockform, and the new lineup of cases for no matter where life takes you. Both the rugged and crystal cases feature the integrated MagMax Forms complete and AirPods together without having to adjust anything. These features will be available in a software update later this fall. You don't have to go out and buy a new AirPods Pro 2, just a software update later this year. Now, before we get into the rest of this video, I want to take a second to tell you about today's sponsor, Rockform, and the new lineup of cases for the iPhone 16. The all-new Rockform rugged and crystal cases have just been released, and they've been engineered to protect the new iPhone 16 in the toughest of environments. With military-grade drop protection standard, these cases are designed to withstand even the most extreme drops and impacts, keeping your new phone safe no matter where life takes you. Both the rugged and crystal cases feature the integrated MagMax magnets, which delivers the strongest hold available for MagSafe. In addition, both include the built-in Rock Lock mounting system, which unlocks Rockform's complete ecosystem of versatile mounts, giving me the freedom to attach my iPhone to virtually any new camera control button that allows you to adjust very.
Sorry,
Rockform.
I can't get my audio to come up. I mean, the video. So I'm going to put it out, try it again.
It may have done that on purpose because you were trying to fast forward to the ad.
Well, he did that, moved it back.
Yeah, but once I found with those videos, once you try to do that, then it messes you up.
Yeah, that's probably right, but anyway. So let's see if we can.
Oh boy.
Oh.
Keep going. Take it further.
See, it's not going to come up to the. Well, that was a great thing while it lasted, but.
Sorry, Ron.
Can you reload the page and then try it again?
Well, you got to listen to all that again.
Second to tell you about today's sponsor, Rockform, and the new lineup of cases for the iPhone 16. The all-new Rockform rugged and...
Okay, it just cancels out. If you got a minute, I try to get it on the web. Let's see.
While you're playing around with that, This is what I lost.
Oh.
That was Noelle when she was 50 years old and I met her. You can see why I want to try and get pictures of her.
Sure.
Lovely lady.
People thought she was my daughter.
Yeah.
When we got married. I was at the Army headquarters and a young man came up and sought my permission to ask my daughter for a date. And I had to say, I'm sorry, Lieutenant. She's already married. When he said, who's the son of a gun who married her? And I said, you're talking to him. But not only was she beautiful, she could charm people. She went up to a general and got me a job that I could only ever dreamed of doing. I'm pretty sure she could charm buzzards off roadkill.
That's hilarious.
I remember years ago, she was a really nice lady.
And she got a lot of good speakers to come to the meetings. I think she got one fellow from Schaefer's photography shop who came and told us that digital photography is just a flash in the pan. It'll always be film.
Well,
that prediction lasted well.
I mean, pretty much digital photography is pretty much taken over now, hasn't it?
Sure.
If they're doing movie
videos. That's what I'm thinking, honestly to God.
Actually, film photography is coming back.
Oh, really?
It is that. It's like the vinyl records. It's a, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like retro. Where do you even buy film like that?
I remember, but by far the most used camera in the world is the iPhone.
Yeah. So
not even close.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't.
How are we doing there?
I'm not finding it. Mac Rumors, here it is.
You know, while Ron's looking for that, I have a sneaky suspicion. I won't be shocked if all of a sudden Apple has a small event.
Apple started the keynote with the announcement of the latest Apple Watch lineup. And this year, we have the brand new Apple.
Okay, hold on. Whoops. That won't work.
Anyway, I noticed that they didn't say anything about Mac OS or Watch OS. It'll be coming out this fall, so I won't be shocked if we see another little event with something. It won't be a big keynote, but something where we might hear more about this stuff.
Right.
Well, even iOS 18, they didn't delve on it a lot.
Yeah.
Apple Watch Series 10. The Apple Watch Series 10 has been updated to feature its biggest display ever.
Okay, can you actually see that guy?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Let me fast forward. This is off the web, so it should work.
Okay.
There you go.
Rock form.
There you go.
Up. And starting with the new standard iPhone 16 models, we see the new colors immediately popping with that color-infused back glass now available in ultramarine, a teal, pink, and of course, white and black color options. The screen is now updated to be 2000 nits of peak brightness while outside, and the iPhone 16 now has the customizable action button that was on the iPhone 15 Pro models last year. There's also the new camera control button that allows you to adjust various camera controls by sliding your finger or using different press gestures. The iPhone 16 is powered by the new A18 chip and features a 16-core neural engine that's optimized for Apple Intelligence features. And we got a bunch of, you know, specs thrown out about a 6-core CPU that's 30% faster than the 15 and 60% faster than the iPhone 12. And it also uses 30% less power, making this more energy efficient. And as for the GPU, there's a 5-core GPU that's 40% faster than the previous model and uses 35% less power. Apple then went over a bunch of Apple Intelligence features that we already knew about and was introduced at WWDC, like Genmoji, Image Playground, finding images faster in the Photos app, and creating memory movies, and even all of the new updated Siri with personal context. Apple Intelligence will be officially available next month in a limited fashion and in limited languages, but more support in languages over the course of the next year. As for the iPhone 16 specific features, there's a new visual intelligence feature for that new camera control button. So if you're out on a walk and you see a restaurant that you've never seen before, all you do is press on the camera control button and point it at the restaurant and then click, and you'll be able to get a new card on that restaurant with all of the information that you might need. Same thing with a flyer for the event. It'll automatically add all the details to a calendar. If you see a dog out in the wild that you don't know about, it can identify the dog, and so on and so forth. Camera Control also can use third-party tools like ChatGPT or even Google Search something for you. This visual intelligence feature will come to Camera Control later in the year. As for more Camera Control features, Apple highlighted that a click will launch the camera app, which is great, and then you can go ahead and click it again immediately to take a photo, or you can click and hold for video. And it's all capacitive, so just different levels of, you know, touch gestures will give you different things. If you lightly press on it, it will reveal a clean UI of the shot, kind of giving you an idea of what other things you can do with an overlay, and you can swipe back and forth to adjust things like zoom, or you can press lightly again to adjust other things like depth of field. And Apple highlighted that third-party apps like Snapchat will also be able to leverage Camera Control. With the new camera design going from diagonal to vertical on the iPhone 16 and 16 Plus, you can now take spatial photos and videos that can be enjoyed on your Apple Vision Pro. The iPhone 16 has a bigger battery as well, and along with the power efficiency of the A18 chip, we can expect a bigger boost in battery life, according to Apple. The iPhone 16 starts at $799 and $899 for the Plus models at a 128 gig base storage model. And then Apple finally introduced the brand new 16 Pro and 16 Pro Max. And the iPhone 16 Pro now comes in at 6.3 inches, and the 16 Pro Max will come in at 6.9 inches. The bezels have been greatly reduced in order to achieve this size increase with minimal form factor changes. The frame is still made in that titanium, but now comes in black, white, natural, and a new desert titanium gold color. And for those wondering, I do actually like this color, but I think overall, the Pro colors really need to be spiced up, hopefully in the future, but I'd love to know your thoughts more on these colors in the comments down below. The iPhone 16 Pro Max is also claiming to have some of the better battery improvements, saying that it is the best battery life ever, and so that's the model I'm gonna go with so I can get the best battery life. The iPhone 16 Pro and Pro Max is now running the new A18 Pro chip. That's obviously going to be faster and more efficient than last year's 17 Pro chip. The new CPU is apparently the fastest CPU in any smartphone ever. The Pro and Pro Max now features a new 48 megapixel fusion camera for the main wide angle sensor and a new 48 megapixel ultra wide sensor. The tetraprism periscope lens is bringing the optical 5x zoom to the standard Pro model and is not just limited to the iPhone 16 Pro Max. There are new photographic styles that you can even customize and adjust the tone and color of, and styles can be changed after you capture a photo. The camera control lets you easily navigate through those styles by just swiping back and forth on that button. The iPhone 16 Pro now takes 4K 120 frames per second slow motion video thanks to that new 48 megapixel fusion sensor. And you can also capture 4K 120 ProRes and log video directly to an external storage device. You can also adjust the frame rate after you take the video inside of the Photos app. The iPhone 16 Pro has 4 studio quality mics for audio recordings and lets you take spatial audio capture during video for AirPods and Apple Vision Pro. Apple also announced a new audio mix feature that uses machine learning and identifies and separates background elements for what's happening in frame and lets you isolate that recording so that the background noise doesn't disturb what is happening in frame. And then there's a cinematic audio mode mix, which will intelligently blend both background and in-frame noise in order to get that perfect level. In the Voice Memos app, you can also record a note with like a guitar track, and then if you have a vocal idea that you want to layer on top for reference later, you can even do that too. And lastly, Apple also mentioned some new MagSafe cases that work well with the new camera control, and there's a new MagSafe charger that offers faster wireless charging in 2 different sizes, and the iPhone 16 now supports Qi2 charging. The iPhone 16 Pro starts at $999 for the 128 base model, and the Pro Max starts at $1099 for the 256 storage model. You can pre-order all of the new iPhones starting this Friday, with shipments going out the following Friday on September 20th. And that's it. Would love to know your thoughts on the Glowtime Fall iPhone 16 event in the comments down below. Are you planning on picking up anything? Please let us know down in those comments. This is
MacRumors. Thanks so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you around in the next video.
Okay, sorry for the misstep there, but
no problem. Thanks, Ron. I think there's some great products, but you know, it's funny, a lot of people raise their hand, they're talking about getting something. I think this is going to be something where I'm impressed by the products, but I won't be buying anything.
Well, you already have almost all the stuff, Glenn.
Honestly, the oldest thing that I have right now is probably my MacBook. It's an M1, but yeah, I mean, most of my stuff is up to date, you know, pretty up to date. So, but I will miss having that extra button on, you know, the iPhone, because the 15 doesn't have it. I think that's really handy, you know, because if you're sitting here wanting to take a photo, whether you're doing it this way or you're holding it this way, it's nice to have that control, you know, right at your fingertip there, without having to look at the screen and go in and do stuff on the screen.
I think that's true. Well, thanks everybody for tonight. Richard, I hope you have success in your venture. Okay.
Ron.
Thank you, Ron.
I know we don't have a lot of time and I can't fully go, but I know some of you wanted me to go back over some of the AI stuff.
I totally spaced.
Well, here's what I was going to suggest. So for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, so last month, if you were with us, I was doing something on some AI sites, but you know, we got backed up and I kind of blew through my presentation in about 10 minutes. And so I know a few of the officers said, hey, it'd be great if you could go back and do that more slowly and we could see it and play with it. Well, obviously, you know, it's 8:48 now. I don't have a lot of time. So I thought, why don't we do this? I don't have to necessarily make it one big thing, but maybe I could hit one, you know, each month as we go on, or whatever I can hit, or when we have time, I can just hit one or two of the sites.
Well, even next month, it's only iOS 18. Maybe it can fit in there.
So if you guys want, I can hit like one of them now, or I can just leave it till next month.
Whatever you think, Glenn.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you what then. Let's just leave it, because it's already like 10 minutes till. I'd rather be able to play and have you guys play some with it and test some of the stuff out. So we can just come back to that next month. That's not a problem. Although I did find, of those 10 that I presented, one of them no longer functions in this region. So we're down to 9.
Well, there might be other stuff coming out too. You never know.
And by the way, I would love to put out there to our members, if anybody, you know, buys one of these new products and you would like to do a product review for us, you know, at an upcoming meeting, let us know. We would love for you guys to do that. Or if there's just a topic that anybody would like to present on, because, you know, so often it's just a few of us doing the presentations, and we would love for other people to jump in. I think it makes it more interesting when more people are presenting. So if there's anything that anybody thinks would be interesting that they'd like to present on, you know, let us know. We'll be happy to accommodate that.
Yeah, for sure.
John, are you still there with us?
I am.
Okay. Did you want to mention something about trivia?
December. At the officers' meeting, we were talking about, I raised the question of whether or not trivia has been going on for a while and has now gotten kind of stale. And we were talking about the possibility of keeping on with trivia, changing it somehow. We also talked about the possibility of having another joint meeting with Cap Mac. And if we did that, would Cap Mac be interested in having a trivia presentation? Glenn, I don't know if
you've had them find out since then.
John, I sent a couple of their officers an email after, you know, the morning after we had our meeting, and I have not heard back. I'll follow up again, you know, with them.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. They seem to take their time in getting back to us.
Yes.
Well, you know, the subject came up of whether in for December, we could do something as an, well, could we do something as an alternative to trivia and just drop trivia from the December meeting altogether? Another possibility was having a joint meeting with Cat Mac in December and then seeing whether they were interested in having a trivia presentation. They may not be interested in it in the slightest, in which case, okay, we just wouldn't have it. Now, if we don't have a meeting with Cat Mac, and as Glenn knows all too well, they kind of take their sweet time in getting back to us, then I guess we had talked about the possibility of having a physical get together.
No, John, do not mention that.
Okay.
I do not think that's possible. And I don't want to bother to even try to figure it out.
Well, I'm just talking, these are the things that we had talked about. But
Yeah, I know.
if that's kind of off the table, then so be it. But
Well,
no, I
I think what John we were talking about want to know is, we've been doing trivia, but it's kind of gotten smaller. We didn't have a lot of people last year. Is it something that still interests everybody in doing?
I just think last year was kind of easy.
If anybody has any opinions, just put them in the GAMUG list.
Yeah.
Okay.
I liked to kind of be challenged with a thing and then learn things too, because oftentimes you come up with interesting facts that I couldn't think of, but you learn something about it.
Well, we'll see. The number of participants at the December meeting have been quite low. We were scraping the bottom of the barrel to try to get enough to have two teams, whereas in the past, we would have as many as four teams. So
Well,
I took that to mean that the interest in trivia
we
really
only
might.
have 23 members total.
Agreed,
So,
agreed. But I mean, we had what did we have? Do we have like eight people are showing up for the meeting in last December? So certainly many, many fewer than we have now. If that is the case, and if trivia is something that people are not interested in anymore, that's fine. We'll think of something else to do in December, joint meeting with Cat Mac or whatever it might be. But I it,
question. If we scrub the trivia, how will we reallocate the budget for the trivia gift cards?
Well, there wouldn't be gift cards if we don't have the trivia.
So
We would
how would
have.
those funds be reallocated?
They would just stay in the treasury. We wouldn't have to allocate them at all. They would just stay in the treasury. We would for the If we do not have a trivia contest, then the money we would have spent on those gift cards would stay in the treasury. We would still, of course, have the membership rewards program because we do that twice a year, but we would not, in addition to that, have the Apple gift cards that we were giving people who won the trivia contest.
Would it be possible to say if you're not there at the meeting in December, you can't win? I know that's not very popular, but it could
No.
boost the attendance.
Well, I don't want to do anything like that just to sort of, compel people to come in and listen to a trivia contest. If people are not interested in it, that's fine. And as I say, the interest in it has definitely waned. If the interest in it has waned to the point now that people don't want to do it anymore, that's fine. We will think of something else to do. But again, if anybody has any thoughts about it, even if you're not sure now, compose your thoughts later, put it in GAMUG list and share it with the rest of us, and we'll see what comes.
John, I know I'm just speaking for myself. I still enjoy it. I like it that it's a change of pace just from the normal meeting. And so I appreciate that that you put the effort in and for us and everything. So I'd like to do it again, but we'd like to hear everybody's opinions.
I would be
Okay.
happy to play the trivia again too.
Yeah, I actually enjoy the whole evening. So the only it's kind of a shame that we can't share Christmas cookies like we used
Yeah,
to.
I'll send them to you in the mail, Ron.
Yeah,
Well, I hopefully I can hear back from Cap Mac because maybe they'd be interested. And now, we would have a whole bunch more people. So, I would say, I'll try to reach out to them again and see if I can, you know, hear something back from them in the next week or two. And, you know, I mean, we still have some time here to decide.
Okay, that'll work.
Okay, guys, thanks a lot for coming. And I'm going to sign off now. Is that okay?
Yep.
Okay.
Good night.
Okay. Good night. Bye-bye.